What is happening is that geographically, the old city is becoming renovated. The old city is along the crescent of the river and roughly from Dryades or St. Claude Street back down to the river. Then the second generation old city, which is from those streets, say Dryades back out to Broad and from St. Claude back out to Broad, they are taking strength from the earlier renovation along the French Quarter, Garden District, Lower Garden District, Crescent, and moving back up into the old part of the city and renovating from there. So that in effect, these renovations have fed one on another, one giving strength to another. Renovation is the ball game, from the industrial canal to the parish line, from the river to the lakefront.
So what kind of effect has this had on residential patterns in the old city?
Well, many cases, there's a beautiful British word for this. They call it gentrification, the moving of the gentry into the old neighborhoods, all right? And let's say that that's kind of a cutesy term. What it really means is that you're replacing, in many instances, lower income, blue collar people of both black and white, blue collar families, with more highly educated, more affluent families with fewer children, and in many cases with a different pattern of lifestyle.
This side effect of the renovation movement, is often forgotten in the city's rush to welcome the middle-class renovators and the tax revenue they provide. But the way the displacement situation is handled could have an important impact on all residents of New Orleans. Is displacement a problem? Who's it happening to? What causes it? And what can be done about it?
It's a problem all over New Orleans. In any place where you've got, where you have a group of people that don't fit into the economic mainstream of today, and we're just not really addressing it.
We're talking about elderly people whose days of earnings are behind them. They're living on fixed income and they're subject to the whims of whatever inflation does to them. You're talking about broken families, let's say female-headed households, where the earning capacity of the mother is very seriously reduced by a number of factors, lack of child care facilities, lack of education, and so forth. And then probably the third category that's being displaced is the one that's least talked about and probably the least harmful, which is the transient population category.
Social service agencies have found that many displaced people are senior citizens who are especially hurt by the hardship of suddenly having to move a lifetime of possessions. And most displacees would prefer not to leave their old neighborhoods. But the renovation continues. The magnitude of displacement itself varies from neighborhood to neighborhood. But according to community observers, it's happening all over the so-called old city, from uptown to downtown, in white neighborhoods as well as black ones.
Moving day, moving day. Rip the carpet up off the floor. Get on your overcoat and out the door, because it's moving day. Pack up your clothes and get away. If you can't pay your rent, gotta live out in a tent, because it's moving day.
Is displacement a problem in Marigny?
Well, it's definitely happening in Marigny. There's been a very visible change in the neighborhood, in buildings going from large number of units to smaller number of units, where maybe something that had been a double was made into a fourplex. There have been certain buildings, like the big one on Washington Square, that was a total disaster, that's been renovated. It went from 13 apartments to three.